Welcome to Adala's Backyard Garden. This video is about repotting of a cayenne pepper plant that we started from seed some time ago. Now for the repotting, this is the plant that we will be using, and this is the pot that we'll be repotting it in, and the potting mix that we use is the one that we have made at home, and we have a video for that, how we make our own potting mix. So you can refer to that if you want to see what exactly goes into this potting mix. So we have our potting mix right here with us. We have some earthworm casting, some all-purpose fertilizer and some bone meal with us. So half of the pot is filled with potting soil, and now we are adding all three of them: earthworm casting, bone meal and all-purpose fertilizer. We add some more of the potting mix and then we basically layer each one of them. I save a lot of the earthworm casting to be added to the top of the soil rather than everything at the bottom. So I'm just using a sprinkling of it in the bottom layers, as you can see. As you can see that when we pot up any of our plants like peppers, tomatoes, bottle gourds, all the different types of gourds and also eggplants, we give very good nutrition in the initial phase itself so that the plants have good growth and they're healthy looking plants. Now if your saplings are really tiny, one good amendment that you can use is the earthworm casting. They are so good. They'll give your plants a good boost initially, and also if you do not run the risk of burning your plants. Sometimes if you add a whole lot of fertilizers, it can burn up your plants, so you have to be very careful in how much you add, especially synthetic fertilizers. You just need very little quantity because they are very strong and you just want to use it with a lot of discretion. Now this pepper plant that I started a few months ago, I believe, is not the healthiest of the plants that I have had, but this is the long variety of the cayenne pepper, and I really like this pepper, so I didn't want to throw it. I just thought I can repot this and see how this pepper plant does once it gets all the nutrition it needs. Now when you repot or transplant any of your saplings during the peak of summer, you want to take extra precaution to keep it in a shaded region so that it is not directly under sun for at least 2 to 3 weeks. Once the roots have all picked up well and have established themselves, that's when you want it to have some sun, and you know, water these plants well during this 2 to 3 week period. Also be careful not to overwater them and cause root rot. Once you repot your pepper plants, water them thoroughly. Also, I do not prune my pepper plants. I have not seen much benefit in pruning the pepper plants. They anyway grow bushy, so I am not bothered to prune any of my pepper plants. I have 2 mature pepper plants which I've been having since the last 3 years. I always overwinter them. And you can see that from the start of April, I start seeing blooms because these are really established pepper plants. I also continuously fertilize my pepper plants throughout the summer months, so they give me pretty much a continuous supply until September. When we have some excess pepper, we always wash, pat dry and deep freeze them. We use these peppers during the winter months. Every March, I add some compost and fertilizer to these plants, and on a regular basis, between 10 to 15 days, I give them liquid fertilizer so they keep producing. Now, these are the few produce that we got in the past week. If you like these kind of videos, please like, share and subscribe to our videos. Thank you.